Good morning all. Yesterday I am discussing about, in previous class I am discussing about external environmental analysis. So under external environmental analysis, there are three environments are there. One is general environment, and second one is industrial environment, and third one is international environment. These three environments are there. So first one, general environment. Now we are discussing about general environment. So general environment, in general environment, the firm is said to be more effective when its strategy caters to the needs, effective when its strategy caters to the needs of the environment. So when you formulate a strategy in an effective manner, then automatically the strategy fulfills the needs of the environment. Okay, so in general, the basic requirement of the strategy is, if your strategy is effective, then it will fulfills all the needs of the environment. So that is the basic characteristic of the, or a basic requirement of a good strategy. Okay, so basic requirement of a good strategy. So the additional features added to the main product at times could provide a new life to the main product. Suppose if you are adding some more features to the existing product, already it is there in the market, and we are adding some of the features and additional features to that product, then you give new life to that product, new look and a new design and new features. So ultimately it feels it is a new product in the customer perspective, but in your perspective it is old product, because already it is there in the market with your brand name. Just you remodel it and you are giving new life. That means regeneration. Okay, that means regeneration. So the corporate units which realize this will survive in the long run. So those companies or those corporates are following this type of strategies, then they survive in long run. Already we are discussing in this same thing in the product life cycle. Okay, in the product life cycle itself, so growth and saturation stages are there. So in the growth and saturation stages, you will keep the stages in as long as possible with only possible is you are introducing a new product or you redesign your product. That means you are giving new life to your product. Okay, then only you are sustained in the market. Okay, so the major causes of growth decline and other large scale changes in firms are the factor in the external environment, not internal environment. So what are the major causes of growth decline and other large scale changes in firms are the factor in the external environment, not internal environment. Suppose if you want to grow, so the major causes of growth, that means the business is in a growth stage and the decline stage or any other changes in the firm, there is the only reason is external factors, not the internal factors. Okay, so the growth and decline and other large scale changes are only completely depending upon the external factors. Those are came from external environment, not from internal environment. So simply it is called as pest analysis. So I'm not mentioned here. There is a pest analysis. For this analysis, we completely understand what it is. Okay. So just in your syllabus, they are giving socio-economic sector, technological sector, the government sector. Okay, there are three. So pest is also same. Pest means P for political and E for economical, and S for social and T for technological. Both are same. There is no difference at all. But technically, they are giving in this way, socio-economic sector and the technological sector and the government sector. So that's why I mentioned here, but it is simply called as pest analysis. So pest, in pest analysis, political environment, economical environment, and social environment and technical environment, four. Okay, so government will be considered as technical, government is considered as political, and remaining three are common. Socio and economic is combined in single item, and technology sector is different. Okay, so separately mentioned, right? So now I am elaborating these things. Okay, so political sector. So the politics shows a major impact on the business sector. Okay, so according to the government policy, the government policy should prepare by the leading party. That means any political party. So any political, any leading political party in the state or central, they are from the government. The government policy, the industrial policies are completely depends upon the leader's view. That means our PM or CM. The government policy itself represents party policy. Okay. So in one party government, the policies are different. And in another party government, there is different policies. Okay. So one government gives some priorities to some sectors, and another government is giving some sectors priority. Okay. So suppose if you are taking Modi government, that is BJP government, the BJP government is completely focusing on Made in India. They are focusing on startups and like this, and they are giving top priority to the industrial sectors development. Okay. And in Congress government, they are also giving priority to the industrial sector, but they are mainly focusing on the agriculture sector and remaining sectors. Okay. So in this way, the priorities will be changed according to the government policy. So government is nothing but any leading party in the country, which is formed the government. So their views are representing in their policies. That's why the political environment or government sector will show huge impact on the business. Suppose the government encourages solar energy right now. So they are giving maximum benefits to that industry. So they are giving subsidy for the customers, those who are want to start putting solar panels and solar power systems in their houses or in their fields. Government is encouraged them to give subsidy, those who are interested to put solar plants. Okay, so it reflects, it shows impact on the solar business sector, because interested people are ready to start solar plants because the government is giving subsidy. So the business of the solar is in a increased manner or growth. Okay, so ultimately there is a growth in the solar industry. So because the government is encouraged that sector, so ultimately the people are also taking that advantage, and they are also ready to start solar plants. Okay, so in this way, the government is showing impact on the business. Okay, so this is external environment. And next one, socio-economic sector. So socio-economic sector is also very, very important. So socio-economic sector means some social changes are also shows huge impact on the business sector. So social changes means, so the social conditions of India and the remaining countries are different. So in India, some of the social conditions are there, and in America and in London and Europe culture is different. and American culture is different, and Arabic culture is different. So in this way, and South African, African culture is different. So in this way, the social and cultural conditions are changed from one country to the another country. So if you want to start a business in America, then you understand what is the culture of the America. So you need to know what are the conditions, cultural conditions in the America. So then only you start the business in a successful manner. You launch your business in a successful manner. Otherwise you fail. Because your product is against their culture. Okay. So ultimately it leads to problem. Okay. Suppose if I taking protest of armies, sipahi. So telugula manam sipahi udyamam anna. So why it is comes in bullets of the guns, they are prepared with the pig fat. They are prepared with the pig fat. So if you install a bullet in the gun, then you need to open the seal of that bullet with mouth. So Muslims are hating pig, any content from the pig, they are they didn't accept to touch or put in the mouth. They don't eat the pig meat. Okay, so all of you know that, I think. So because the traditional culture of that religion is different. Okay, so they are rejecting to use that bullets. Then it leads to some revolution like this. So traditions and social conditions are changed from one religion to another religion, and one country to the another country, and laws are different from one country to another country. Then you have to know all the cultures and the social conditions of that country. Then you launch your product, and then you start your business according to the which country you have to select. Then first you have to know all the things about this. That is very, very important. Then economic sector. So economic sector is also very, very important. So economic sector means economic conditions of the one country to another country is also different. Because in our country, there is one tax policies, and in another country, there is some different tax policies. And rules and regulations are also changed. So we are encouraging the privatization and deregulation, Indian government. But in some countries, there is a lot of restrictions while you are entering into the business. And there is some tax conditions are different from our country to another country. So it is not easy to start the business without knowing all these things. And this shows a major impact on our business. Suppose if you want to take an example, suppose you went to some backward countries, they are giving 100% tax benefits. You didn't pay any tax to that particular government. Those who are interested to start that start their businesses in that country. So many investors are going to start their businesses in that tax benefits countries, tax free countries. So because they start their head office in that particular country, then all the income goes to that particular country, then there is no tax. So 100% tax benefit. So all your money is white money. So you need not pay to any single penny to the government. Why? They are encouraged in that manner. Because they are nobody started business in that countries. So they are attracting the investors to invest the money in that country because of unemployment. So when the investors are start their businesses in that country, then automatically the employment will be created. So that is giving benefit to that particular country, that people. In this way, they are generating the income. But the government losses income tax, there is no problem at all, because they get the benefit in another way. Employment will be generated and the people are earning money, and after that they are paying the taxes to the government. Okay, in this way they are getting benefited from the industrialization in this way. Then after that, the technological sector. So technological sector is also very, very important. So many new type of technologies are introduced into the different sectors, because the technology shows huge impact on the business sector. Nowadays, every business is related with the help of the technology only. Suppose if you see Discovery Channel, Discovery Science, I think. So many products are completely manufactured with the use of machines only. Suppose if you take potato chips in a simple manner, so the boiling of potatoes, and after that it will be peeled by the machines, and after that the layers are also cutted by the machines, and after that they are fried in the oil, that is also machine, 100 degrees Celsius, and after that the oil is which is the oil which is absorbed by the lays, that will be removed by the another machine, another process, and after that the packing also done by the machines, and after that it will be stored in a boxes. That is only manual. That is the thing is only done by manual. So the remaining things are all completely automated. So the technology shows huge impact. So the technology is upgraded. Okay. So then you have to adopt what are the changes occurred in the technology and what are the new technologies are introduced in the market. Then you have to adopt. Then only you are also able to compete with your competitor. Then you are effectively manage competition from outside, because competition is not in internal environment, not inner within the organization. So competition is always came from outsiders, from the competitors. That's why there is a huge competition in every business. Then you overcome this competition, then you adopt new technologies and you change your production process in a regular manner according to the new technology, and you are introducing new technology into your organization. Okay, in this way you are benefited from the new technology. Okay, so this is about general environment. And after that, industry environment. So industry environment is also important component of the overall environment analysis as input for corporate planning. So industry refers to the group of firms carrying on similar activity. It has three sectors: customers, suppliers, and competitors. In industry environment, there are three major groups are there. One is customers, and second one is suppliers, and third one is competitors. So customers are very, very important. That's why we are mentioning in the first one, mentioned as the first one, customers. So the strategist must identify and analyze the customers for the organization, locates the potential customers and the emerging changes in their buying pattern. So the strategist must identify and analyze the customers for the organization, locates the potential customers and the emerging changes in their buying pattern. So for our product, who are the customers? Identification of the customers, those who are willing to buy our product, then the strategist must identify that people, okay, that is nothing but targeted customers. That is very, very important. And also, what are the changes in their buying pattern? Okay, so buying pattern is changed according to the situation and also according to the requirement. Okay, so according to the requirements of the customer, the buying pattern will be changed. So according to that, the strategist to identify and analyze the changes in the buying pattern of the customers, and they give and they fulfill the requirements of the customer. Okay, that is very, very important. So it is necessary to identify the profile of buyers in terms of their needs and preferences based on the basic demographic factors such as age, income size of household, and consumption pattern. So after that, the strategist must identify the profile of the buyers according to the demographic, that means area wise factors. So already I told you, example is, suppose you start a razor business in the Punjab. So it is completely failure because nobody is shave in the Punjab. Okay, because they didn't shave. So why you start that business in that particular area? That is useless. That is meaningless. Okay, only some people, those who are not belonging to the Punjab and Sikh religion, they are only shave. Okay, so rest of the people are completely follow their tradition. So that is one factor. So that is demographic factor and age group. So some type of products are buying some age group people and some type of products are buying some age people. So you have to differentiate and identify the age group, which age group people are buying which type of products. That is also very, very important. So depending upon the age, the requirement is also different. Okay, suppose income size of household. So the income is also very, very important. Suppose your product is costly product, then the middle class people are not ready to buy that product. Because that is a prestigious product, that means only status symbol. Suppose I am ready, I want to purchase iPhone, but my income level is not up to that mark. So I am unable to buy this product. I have desire, but I don't have that purchase capacity, purchase capability. That is important. Purchasing power. Okay, so I am willing to buy, but my purchase power is not suitable for iPhone. Okay, that is important. Okay, so konalana korukunte saripodandi, konagalige shakti undali. That is clear. Okay, done. These factors create the primary demand for products or service and help to scan the geographical environment for potential market and customers. So in this way, you have to estimate the demand of the primary demand of the product or service according to the geographical area, and you have to identify the potential customers in the market. Okay, then next one, suppliers. Suppliers is also important. So strategist also must determine the availability and cost of supply condition, including raw materials, energy, prevailing technology, money and labor. The supplier can influence a firm its strategy, particularly when the firm is outsourcing its logistic requirements. After that, suppliers, that means those who are supplying the raw materials and energy and the technology and money and labor, these are also very, very important. The availability is very, very important. The supplier can influence a firm and its strategy. Suppliers also influencing the strategy of the organization, particularly when the firm is outsourcing its logistic requirements. In this situation, suppose the company is completely depending upon the outsourcing. for the logistic requirements, that means raw materials, energy, and for all these things, the company is totally depending upon the outsiders. Then the suppliers shows major impact on the strategy. Okay, that is suppliers, about suppliers and competition. So competition is also very, very important. The strategist molds his strategy in the light of the competitor's strategy, the exist or entry of competitors to be analyzed and diagnosed. Okay, so competition is also very, very important. Depends upon the competitors, then you have to change your strategy and mold your strategy according to the competitor strategy. The exit or entry of competitors to be analyzed and diagnosed. So who are entry into the market and who are exit from the market? Okay, so why they are exiting from the market and why are they entering into the market? That means why means there is a chance, there is a chance really is there to enter new competitors in the market, and what are the reasons, you have to find out that. And exit from the market, why they are exiting from the market, is there any difficulty in the present market scenario or any downtrend in that particular business, then you have to identify all these things. According to this, you have to change your strategy, because you want to run your business in a long run. Then you have to find out all the reasons for exit and entry of the competitors into the market. It is completely analyzed and diagnosed. That is about competition. Next, third one is international environment. So international environment is also very, very important one, important component. The strategy of globalization implies a great source of opportunities and also threats to business firms, such firms which can make use of the opportunities would flourish, and those which cannot get up would demise. Okay, so the strategy of globalization. So while you are integrating your business with global scenario, that means you elaborate, you expand your business to number of nations or number of countries. So there is a great source of opportunities and also a threat to business firms. So there is a chance to opportunities and there is a chance to threats. Okay, because you are starting anything, always all the things are positive. Some of the things are also negative. So there is a problems, and also there is your opportunities. So you are using opportunities in an effective manner, and you overcome which are the threats in the market or external environment, then only you will be success. Such firms which can make use of the opportunities would flourish, and which cannot get up would demise. Suppose if you miss the opportunity and you are not correctly utilizing the opportunities which are came from the external environment in an effective manner, then you will be demise. That means you getting losses in the business. If you are effectively used, then your business will be flourishing. That means in a growth manner. So the international environment is very, very important while you are entering into the global market. So you have to analyze the international factors, not only your country. You have to focus on all the countries which you have to enter into that business. Okay, so you have to know about all these things. Okay, so internal environment analysis and diagnosis. So tomorrow we will discuss about that. So that's up to you. That's